we had seen that the highest court of the country, the Supreme Court, gave its judgment on Rafael. There were a set of petitioners who had appealed to the highest court, the Supreme Court, basically on three issues of Rafael. The issue number one was, of course, an allegation by them, which is the same allegation by the Congress party, that there was some kind of problem, there was some kind of procedural problem in procuring Rafael. The second issue on which these petitioners went to the Supreme Court was on the price. Allegation was there was escalation of the price. Mr. Rahul Gandhi and the Congress party also made these allegations. And the third important issue on which the petitioner had approached the Supreme Court was commercial favoritism. And you would be reminded of the fact as to how Mr. Rahul Gandhi time and again had come out and said that 30,000 crore has been taken out of your pocket and of my pocket and has been given to some industrialist. On all these three counts, the Supreme Court gave a detailed hearing. In fact, even demanded the price details from the central government, which was shared with the Supreme Court in a closed envelope. Thereafter, the Supreme Court's judgment came a few days ago. And let me begin by just reading the conclusion, because the conclusion says it all. Para 34, page 28, the conclusion says, in view of our findings on all the three aspects and having heard the matter in detail, we find no reason for any intervention by this court on the sensitive issue of purchase of 36 defense aircraft by the Indian government. Perception of individuals cannot be the basis of a fishing and roving inquiry by this court, especially in such matters. This is extremely important issue. As I was telling you, the three important aspects which even the Supreme Court mentions in its conclusion, that all the three aspects on which there were allegations and complaints, the procedure, the pricing and commercial favoritism, has been delved in detail, and thereafter we come to the conclusion that no investigation is required. No investigation is required. Secondly, and very importantly, what the Supreme Court says is that perception of few individuals or parties, etc., does not form the basis of forming an opinion that an investigation is required. This says it all. Despite all this conclusion by the highest court of the country, we see Mr. Rahul Gandhi and the Congress party trying to spread lies. My suggestion through this press conference, in form of a question to the extremely intelligent people of India, and more so in Kerala, is, whom do you believe more? The esteemed justices of the Supreme Court, including the Chief Justice of the Supreme Court, or a politician who is himself out on bail? Because, let me remind you, it is because of the Indian judicial system that the wrongdoings of both Mrs. Sonia Gandhi, the former president of Congress party, and Mr. Rahul Gandhi, the present president of Congress party, accused number one, Sonia Gandhi, and accused number two, a National Herald case, both of them are out on bail. So the people who are out on bail are the ones who are accusing, abusing this judgment. They are questioning the credibility of the Supreme Court of India. This has become the hobby of some politicians in India to in fact cry horse when they don't get a judgment which favors them. We had seen the same in previous instances as well. Most importantly, what has been said of Anil Ambani's company Reliance, the accusation that the Bharatiya Janata Party's central government had doled out some kind of favoritism in favor of this private company, is completely bunkum, is false, and this is what the Supreme Court says on it. I read out paragraph 33. We do not find any substantial material on record to show that this is a case of commercial favoritism to any party by the Indian government, as the option to choose the IOP, that is the Indian offset partner, does not rest with the Indian government. The Indian government had nothing to do with selection of the Indian offset partner, which Mr. Rahul Gandhi and the Congress party had been alleging that the Indian government chose Reliance. This was absolutely wrong, which the Supreme Court says. The question is, if you would read these 29 pages of the Supreme Court judgment, you would realize that the Supreme Court particularly is quite wary about the fact that issues of national security should have been addressed much before. why there was such amount of delay in procuring Rafale, which is a much required instrument, a weaponry for India's defense. This is a question that India asks to the Congress party. For 10 years, the Congress party sat over the deal. For 10 years, the Congress party did nothing. Probably because of the fact that the Congress party is used to middlemen. Probably because Congress party is used to corrupt means. Probably because Congress party is used to graft money. And this was a government to government deal during Mr. Modi's era. The Congress party did not have any Christian Michel Mama uncle or any Quattrochi uncle to fill their deep pockets with black money. And that's the reason as to why probably the Congress party and the Gandhi family in particular could not reach to a conclusion in this deal. The serious question is, Mr. Rahul Gandhi has been using all kind of unparliamentary language against the Prime Minister. When he calls the Prime Minister by a particular name, this is quite offending. Let me tell you, only yesterday we had a verdict by the Delhi High Court. In the 1984 Sikh riots, we had seen as to how Sajjan Kumar, one of the top leaders of the Congress party, has been convicted for life. He has been convicted and he will be imprisoned for life. The question is, those who are murderers are shouting thief, thief. Murderers shouting thief. And this is the reality. Those who have been convicted are alleging impropriety towards others. I firmly believe that after this kind of judgment by the Supreme Court, not an iota of doubt remains in the people of this country. Mr. Rahul Gandhi and the Congress party may try to politicize the whole issue because of the simple fact that they try to manufacture lies every day. Since there is nothing else to offer, people of this country are intelligent. They will see through the design of the Congress party and Mr. Rahul Gandhi. And 2019, of course, is the time when democratically people will answer the Congress's lies. Thank you. Any questions that you would like to ask?
Sir, you just said that the Congress party is unwilling to accept the verdict of Supreme Court, the Honorable Supreme Court verdict. But at the same time, my question is, your party is finding the same verdict, the verdict by the same court, Supreme Court, in Sabarimala issue. How do you take it?
No. We are not questioning any judgment. As has been pointed out by our national president, Shri Amit Shahji, that no one is questioning the Supreme Court. This is a democratic country. We can of course discuss. We are discussing the issue. Mr. Amit Shah has time and again on various forums categorically said that judiciary is to be respected. Every verdict of judiciary is to be respected. There is one verdict of judiciary that if mosques have loudspeakers, those loudspeakers have to be taken down. If the state government of Kerala does not show the same jest or zeal to take down the loudspeakers, why this kind of violence against the devotees? This is what the question the national president of Bharatiya Janata Party, Mr. Amit Shah, has asked. And if I am not wrong, I have great leaders of the state by both my sides. There is some judgment in church case also in Kerala itself. Yes. And the state government is showing no activism in that regard. So why this extra activism upon the devotees of Sabarimala while you are quiet on other issues? The selectivism is what we have questioned.
So you just said that the Congress is not accepting the Supreme Court's verdict, that they are questioning it and they are raising so many questions. So the same is being done by the BJP in the Sabarimala issue. After a constitution bench, so far no women in the age group of 10 to 50 could enter because of all those kinds of protests and attack on women that have happened.
See, as far as the Sabarimala issue is concerned, we have to understand the sensitivity of rituals in any state. I, for instance, am an Odia person, but I respect the sensitivity of this beautiful state of Kerala. And I firmly believe that the selectivism by the state government, which I've already talked about, only reeks in the name of quote-unquote secularism, of cracking down on a particular community, while it is quite reluctant to do the same on another community. This is not fair in democracy. And we respect every judgment of the Supreme Court. Supreme Court is the highest court of the country. To say that the Bharatiya Janata Party does not respect the court judgment would be absolutely wrong. Well, yes, in a democratic country, we can have a fair discussion, which we are all entitled to as citizens of this country.
So, what is BJP stance in the Shabrimala issue? Could you just explain it?
See, I firmly believe that as far as the stand of BJP in the Shabrimala issue is concerned, our state leaders have formulated it on innumerable occasions. Innumerable occasions. Not only by words, but by action also. Benevolent action, I would say. Democratic actions. Hartal. Recently there was a Hartal also. And our national president, whatever he had said on that, I have just now quoted. So I don't believe there is any further need to clarify on this.
So you don't support the entry of women in the age group of 10?
I have already said what our national president has said. And what our local leadership are saying, that is in front of you because every day you talk to them.
Clarity on this part.
Rituals are to be respected, and selectivism is something which we condemn.
And recently, your state party state president has come under attack for saying that it is a political opportunity, golden opportunity for BJP. Do you see the national leadership, do you see it as a political opportunity, a golden opportunity for BJP?
See, the state president himself was questioned and he has given an answer. There is no need as to why I should be answering on his behalf. He has already given the answer. When he has answered, it is okay.
Mr. Patra, there are around 30 women from Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka, Orissa, including Kerala also, who have said that they are going to Shabrimala on 23rd. They have taken the brahmas that are required. What would be the party's stand? Protests, yes. But will they be blocked? Will there be, because they say they have a right from the Supreme Court to go to the temple. You say democratic protests are allowed. To what extent will they be stopped?
See, I'll be cautious in answering this by saying that the local leadership will take a call on this. I would not trespass into a zone which I am not supposed to. I have come here for a press conference on Rafael. And well, yes, you all are entitled to ask questions. You have asked me questions on Shabrimala and I have, to the best of my knowledge, whatever I know, I have answered. But what is the design, what is the pattern that the state government is going to follow in the days to come is something for the state government, state presidentship and the state leadership to decide. And of course, when they decide, they let you know. They're not going to hide anything. So because you're the fourth pillar. Without you all, nothing can be done.
Sir, may I ask you?
Yes,
your Prime Minister is always deputing you people to explain on such matters, which is of national importance and importance to the party as well. Why the PM doesn't come out and explain himself to the media?
First and foremost, he's not my Prime Minister, he's all our Prime Minister. You said your Prime Minister, he's our Prime Minister, India's Prime Minister, equally yours. And secondly, he's not deputing us. The Prime Minister does not depute us to come and speak over here. Very respectfully, I would submit that the party deputes us, of whose I am a national spokesperson. They're all tall leaders sitting by my side. Our duty is to come and have a healthy discussion with you and the people of this country. This is my job. This is my duty. And various, who said that the Prime Minister does not speak? While we are having this press conference, 1 hour ago, in one of the television channels, he was giving a detailed version of what we are speaking today. He was talking about Rafael. He was talking about this judgment. He spoke himself. He never shies away.
No press conference.
See, most of your channels have invited him, have asked him questions. He had given out answers to every question that you ask. A man who is working 24/7 for the benefit of this country. I believe he has taken every question by each channel that is over here. Yes, any more questions, sir? Thank you. Very kind of you for having me here.